Hi, welcome to this video on rational and irrational numbers. Rational and irrational numbers comprise the real number system. This Venn diagram shows a visual representation of how real numbers are classified. The natural numbers comprise the smallest subset, which is also known as the set of counting numbers. These are all positive, non-decimal values, starting at 1. Whole numbers are the natural numbers plus the value of 0. The integer set of numbers includes whole numbers and all negative, non-decimal values. Rational numbers include all the sets seen here, in addition to the fractional values in between. An easy way to remember this is that the word ratio is in the name of this classification. All numbers included in the rational number set can be written as a ratio of integers. If A and B are integers, rational numbers can be written as A over B, as long as B does not equal 0. Clearly, the set of integers can be written as ratios because any integer divided by 1 results in the original integer. As illustrated here, integers can be expressed as fractions in infinite numbers of ways. The integer 3 can be represented as the fractions 3 over 1, 6 over 2, and even negative 24 over negative 8. The integer negative 5 can be represented as the following fractions. And the integer 0 can be represented as the fractions 1. As a side note, these are not the only fractions that result in these integers. They're just a few of the many examples that exist. Fractions can also be written as decimals. For example, 0.1 is equivalent to 1 over 10 because the 1 is in the tenths decimal place. .13 is equivalent to 13 one-hundredths because the 3 is in the hundredths decimal place and the 1 is in the tenths decimal place. .237 is equivalent to 237 over 1,000 because the 7 is in the thousandths decimal place, and so on. These decimals can be written as fractions, so they are considered rational. Other decimals have repeating patterns. These are also considered rational because they can be expressed as a fraction based on the following proof. The repeating decimal 2.17 represents the digits 2.17171717, and so on. So let's try this as a practice problem. Let x equal 2.17, repeating. The repeating decimal is 2 digits long, which represents the hundredths place. So let's multiply both sides of the equation by 100. 100 times x, 2.17 repeating times 100. This results in 100x which is equal to 217.17 repeating. We moved the decimal over 2 spots because we multiplied by 100. Now let's subtract the original equation from this one, meaning minus x and minus 2.17 repeating. So we have 99x is equal to 215. Notice that the repeating portion of the decimal is now eliminated. Solving for x results in dividing both sides by 99. X is equal to 215 over 99. This is a fractional representation of x equal to 2.17 repeating. This proof shows that repeating decimals are also considered rational because they can be written as a fraction of integers. If you plug this into your calculator, you will get something close to, probably rounded, 2.17 repeating. It is important to note that not all decimals are repeating. Some decimals have an infinite number of non-repeating digits and therefore cannot be expressed as a fraction of integers. These types of real numbers are classified as irrational. While there are an infinite number of irrational numbers in the real number system, most commonly used in mathematics are the square roots of non-perfect squares, like square root of 2, for example, and the constants pi and e. The notation for irrational numbers allows for efficiency in math applications. For geometry, you may recall that pi is equal to about 3.14159 for infinity. This is derived from the circumference of any circle and its diameter. Because the decimal value is non-repeating and infinite, we use an approximate value in math applications. Business applications regarding continuously compounded interest employ the irrational value of e, which has an approximate value of 2.718, again, for infinity. Thanks for watching and happy studying.